Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about probability. Probability is the extent to which something is likely to happen. Probability values can range from 0 to 1, or as a percentage, 0 to 100%. Probabilities are not negative and they're not irrational numbers. When we talk about an unlikely event, it just means an event which has a probability of less than 5% of happening. So if you were going to have 17 children, it's very unlikely that you would have 16 boys, right? Something like that. Anything that's less than 5% would be unlikely. Which of these values could not be used to represent a probability? 3/5, 42%, square root of 3, negative 1.8, 0.67, and 1.3. Well, we just said that had to be between 0 and 100, and that we don't have irrational numbers for that. So we couldn't use a square root of 3, which is irrational, or negative 1.8, which is negative, or 1.3, which is more than 1. So we just always want to look at those probabilities as values between 0 and 1. In general, when we look at probabilities, we have an event. An event is any collection of results or outcomes of a procedure. And the sample space is all the possible outcomes that can't be broken down any further. So an example of something where we might want to know the probability is if flipping a coin or rolling a six-sided die. So when we're looking at the event, this first one is flipping a coin. And so my events are H, which is that I get a heads, or T, which I get a tails. So an event is a collection of results or outcomes. So I have one event that's a heads and one event that's a tails. My sample space is a collection of all of those, so my sample space is heads and tails for flipping a coin. That's it. The probability of H is the probability of getting a heads when flipping a coin. And so to get the probability, you just put the number of times heads can occur and then the total sample space on the bottom. Well, when you flip a coin once, you have one chance of getting a heads out of two chances total, because the sample space is two, heads or tails. So when you flip a coin, you have a 50% chance, or 0.500. On this video, and whenever I think about it, I try to round out to three decimal places. We don't want to always round to one decimal place. It's just not a good practice. Usually, if you're doing assignment for an instructor, or on a computerized program or something like that, it will tell you how far to round your values out. So just be reading those directions or listening to those directions. Okay, in the second one, I'm rolling a six-sided die. The event E is rolling a number less than 3. Well, the sample space when you roll a six-sided die is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. I have 6 different outcomes when I'm rolling a sample space, right? So the number of times my event can occur, well, a number less than 3 would be 1 or 2. So there's 2 chances that I can get something that's less than 3. So that's the number on top. And then the number of sample space is 6. So I have 2 out of 6 chance of getting rolling a number less than 3 in one single roll of the die. And then 2 over 6 could be reduced to 1/3. Which as a decimal is 0.333. Of course, we had to round that. And if we asked for a percent, we could say 33.33% or 33 1/3%, depending on how we're asked to give it. Let's look at another example of rolling a dice. This one, I want to roll a number greater than 6. And my sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So the number of times that that can occur is 0. I can never roll something more than 6 because I only have 1 through 6 on my dice, and the number of events in my sample space is 6, but I have 0 over 6. And that's called an impossible event. When your probability is 0, then that's an impossible event, and that's something that I just tried to do that is impossible. In the other one, event C, flipping either a heads or a tails. And my sample space is H and T. So the number of times this can occur. Well, I can either flip a heads or a tails. So those are my 2 options out of 2 options. And so that's 100%. And so that's considered a certain event. So we have a certain event, which means it's going to happen. There's no other way it can't happen. And an impossible event, which means it's not going to happen at all. All right, let's stop there and we'll go on to the next one later. Have a great day.